I'm going to Cammy's. You know she got plenty, plenty food for me to eat.
Mommy, what are you making today?
Today, baby, we making some stuffed shrimp. Ain't them shrimp pretty, y'all? Now, I already had bought some peeled and deveined shrimp, but I made sure I got the one with the shell still on it because I do want the tail on the shrimp still when I'm making this dish. And I know there's some shrimp tail bandits out there, but it ain't that serious. Just eat around it and then throw it in the trash. Now, these shrimp are a size 13 to 15 count per pound. I like big dog shrimp. Always have, always will. After I finished peeling them, I rinsed them off and I dried them really, really well. I say dry really well because don't nobody want no wet shrimp. I rinsed them off one more time just to make sure there are no more shells left on the shrimp because don't nobody want no shells on this shrimp. And now we butterfly the shrimp. I butterfly them by splitting them a little bit further down the middle than they were when I bought them. Now you do not want to go all the way through to the shrimp, but you want to make sure you get as far as possible so when you lay the shrimp down, they lay down kind of flat. Now, if you bought shrimp that wasn't clean and deveined, you could go ahead and do this part while you're cleaning and deveining them. But I hate cleaning and deveining shrimp. Oh my God, it's so disgusting to me. I don't know why. Now, you're going to do this to all the shrimp that you will be using this stuff. This is about good 2 pounds of shrimp right here. Now, yes, this part is a bit tedious, but take your time. Trust me, you do not want to slice through the shrimp because then you got to stuff it another way. Once you get the hang of it, it takes a lot less time to do this part. After I make sure to butterfly all my shrimp perfectly, it start this seasoning process. My favorite process. I got this Chef Mom's Table seasoning. It's called G.O.A.L.S. It is so good. I added about 2 tablespoons of that on my shrimp and also about 2 teaspoons of Old Bay. And then after I put the Old Bay on there, I got some grapeseed oil because I will be baking these and I love to bake with grapeseed oil. And that was all the seasoning that I needed on these shrimp. Now go ahead and get your hands dirty. You can use a spoon or some tongs for this part, but I like to feel and make sure that my shrimp is completely coated in this seasoning, which is why I waited till after I butterflied up to add the seasoning. And now it's time for the crab cake stuff mixture. In a nice size bowl, I cracked 1 egg. I put 2 tablespoons of mayo. I know how y'all feel about mayo, but just trust me, it's gonna be okay. Then I added some Dijon mustard and some W13 sauce. I don't like too much of that sauce in my stuff, but you can add more if you want. Now season it with some garlic powder and onion powder and some Old Bay. Then I chopped up some fresh chives, the real skinny kind, and I added that into it. Once you add all the seasoning and some of that fresh seasoning in there as well, go ahead and start mixing really, really good. So I started off mixing it with the spoon that I used to put the mayo in there to save dishes, of course, you know, but honey, it was not working for me. This mixture needed to be as smooth as possible, and that spoon was not giving what it's supposed to give. So I went ahead and got my little baby whisk, and I started whisking it really, really good until every lump of mayo, every egg is completely incorporated into this mixture. It took about a good minute, minute and a half of mixing. You can use a hand mixture if you want to, but like I said, ain't nobody got time for them dishes. Once it get thick like me, go ahead and add your lump crab. For this, I used 2 8-ounce cans of lump crab. I say cans, even though they came in a plastic cup, but still, that's what I call it. Then I added some fresh parsley and folded my lump crab into the binding mixture. Now, I noticed some lump crab fiends out there, so no, I do not shuck on my own lump crab. I folded in because I do not want to break up too much of the lump crab, but I still want to make sure every piece has some bit of mixture on it. Once everything is mixed up, I'll go ahead and add some crushed crackers. And these should be as fine as me. Crush real fine. Now go ahead and mix them in there. I started off with 1/2 cup of crushed crackers, and then I realized that I needed a little bit more. You want this mixture to resemble a crab cake, so you have to make sure it's going to bind completely so it does not fall apart in the oven once you put it in there with the shrimp. Once I realized that 1/2 cup wasn't going to work, I added a little bit more crushed crackers. Then I mix it while also patting it down to kind of feel if it's thick or not yet. Or you could just simply grab like a small handful and kind of mush it together to see if it's going to stay together. I folded the crackers in for about 30 to 40 more seconds, kept patting it down to make sure everything was incorporated. And then I realized I was good to go and it was ready to go. If you want, you could put this on a pan, on a baking dish, but I used a cast iron skillet. I buttered my cast iron up like I'm about to put some cornbread in that thing. Make sure every part of it has some butter on it because I do not want this shrimp to stick to it. You can use melted butter if you want to make it easier, but I just didn't feel like melting the butter for this one particular portion. And for you butter bandits, no, I did not use the entire tablespoon of butter at the bottom of the pan. I used just enough to coat the bottom layer of the pan in butter so nothing would stick. And then after that, I got about a teaspoon of grapeseed oil and I add that to the bottom of the pan as well. And I thought I was being cute by trying to move it around the pan. That wasn't working, so I got nice and dirty and put my hand in it and mixed it all around. Once the bottom of the pan was completely non-stick and ready to go, it's time to start stuffing dumb shrimps. Now, these shrimp, like I said, if you butterfly them properly, they should be able to lay down and be flat at the bottom like that. Now, you can either eyeball the crab mixture or get a tablespoon and measure it that way. But I just eyeballed it. I grabbed a good old piece, mixed it together, turned it to a little ball, and I stuffed the shrimp with it. I made sure it was completely on the shrimp so it won't fall off. I pushed the tail down at the top a little bit to make sure it is secured, and I kept doing that until the whole pan was full. Now, off camera, I added all the shrimp to the pan that I possibly can, and then I started on the mixture. I really don't think that one was quicker than the other, but it seemed to work a little bit faster for me. Now, make sure you don't put too much of the crab mixture on the shrimp. The shrimp should be able to hold it and hug it perfectly without any of it falling off. And seeing as you butterflied it perfectly, it would sit right on top of it and it'll stay flat the entire time, even while it cooks. You know how shrimp love to curl up when you cook it, but when you slice it down the middle like that and make it butterfly, when you put it in the oven with these crab cake mixtures, it does not fall over. It does not topple. I think all in all, this mixture completely filled all the shrimp and I didn't have any left over. Now I'm going to start lining these up and making sure there's a little bit of space in between each shrimp. I do not want them to touch, only because I want them to cook properly and completely without overcooking. And I know baking shrimp is a little bit scary because you feel like it's going to overcook, but trust me, it did not, and it was good without being rubbery. All while at the same time, the crab cake mixture was cooked completely through. This process took me about 5 to 7 minutes, and while I was doing that, I had some butter melted in the microwave. Why, do you ask? Because I'm going to baste it with butter, duh. Once they get all pretty in the pan like me, go ahead and baste them with a little bit of butter. You don't have to overdo it, just enough for it to brown the crab cake. But also, don't be stingy. Now, while all this was happening, you should have had your oven preheated to 425. I always preheat whatever I'm doing before I even start prepping my meal. It makes it easier for me and for you. Put these shrimps in the oven on 425 for 13 minutes. Then take them out. Look how pretty they are. Now go ahead and baste them with a little bit more butter. You do not have to do this part, but it was good for me. After you make sure they are all basted with butter, put them back in the oven on broil, which is 500, for 2 to 3 minutes. And make sure you watch them. Do not burn them. Once you do that, take them out the oven, let it cool for about 5 minutes, and you're good to go. And now you have these beautiful crab cake stuffed shrimp. And I ate mine with some good old Alfredo. All right, bye.